This is a very, very, very important message I want to share with you all, because there's something I've been noticing going on when communicating with people. It's not new. It's been going on for years, but it's getting more and more intense, and it's starting to trouble me, because I can't say that for sure it has to do with salvation, but there is a scripture that seems to indicate it does have to do with salvation. It certainly has to do with whether or not you know your God or even could know Him. And that is what I'm about to talk to you about, what you believe. And just to go straight to a scripture I want to talk about, Ephesians 4:5 says, "One Lord, one faith, one baptism." Now we know that they have New Age things and all these teachings that cause you to go astray from the truth. And we all argue, I understand we all argue about that. There is hundreds, even thousands of denominations under the heading of Christianity. So they all disagree with each other. That's why my wife and I completely reject all religion. All religion is man-made. All religion is faulty. There is some truth in some of them. I don't know, there might even be truth in most of them. I haven't investigated them all. All I know is, as a general principle, because God does not have a denomination, all denominations are false. All denominations are man. All denominations leave you open to all kinds of lies, no matter how much truth they might have in them. And I do know that some of them actually do have some truth. But that's the problem. The problem is, when you mix lies with the truth, it makes it more palatable to accept those lies, because you can say you have this truth. And that very basic scripture, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, each and every one of those is so crucial. But as soon as you dilute one of them, you can dilute all of them. And your religion, I guarantee you, your religion requires you. It requires you to dilute one of them. Where we came from is all about one Lord, one Lord, one Lord. But the baptism is a baptisms. They call it a package deal. Well, they couldn't see that allows for you to then say, well, come on, you got your baptisms, we got our Lords, we got our different faiths. I mean, you can't just say Jesus is the only way. There's good people out there who believe in God. I know that might sound crazy to you, but people do it all the time. And your baptism lie sounds crazy to me, even though I taught it once upon a time. But it's a weakness in a structure. It's that weak link that breaches our faith. I'm not saying whether or not that means you're lost if you believe in these things, but there's no way you're going to have an intimate relationship with God when you believe in lies. Willfully believe in lies because you choose the concepts and the precepts and the doctrines and the theologies of men. That's what they are. They're of men. There is only one Lord. There's only one faith. There's only one baptism. All of these things that say there's more, and I know people that tell me there's more than one Lord, the Lord Jesus, and His Father is the Lord as well. And they'll say, I know the faith one isn't as common, at least not in explicit terms, but they do teach you that there's different ways. These different religions and denominations teach you there's different ways besides Christ alone. This is dangerous. This is very dangerous, because you know what it does? I keep using that word diminish, because it does diminish Him. It tells you He is something He's not. I'll give you an example. There's a growing belief system about God that He's two people, or that He's one God and Jesus is this other person who is not God. I'm not going to really address that, because that's so out there. I don't even know what to say to those people. That is such a denial of God, it's really scary. I don't know, I really seriously doubt that those people are saved. But for the people in the Trinitarian / Twinitarian, as I like to say, you know that Jesus is God, But here's the problem, where you diminish him. And I'm not saying you're intending to do this because you're believing a lie. I'm not saying you're antichrist, but you're believing in a lie of the antichrist. In the garden, the devil said, you can be as gods. That was his goal, to create other gods. That diminishes God. You are now equal to God. You are just like him. And Jesus, we are told, is God, but he's not our Father. So now you're put in a position, and this is why I get concerned, because people fight, and they fight, and they fight so, well, I don't say viciously, but so passionately to defend that Jesus is not the Father. God is not the Father. That's what they're saying. God is not the Father. There's a person of God who is not the Father. So that's telling you what God is not. And God the Father is not the Son. God is not the Son. In your theology, which God is not, God is a person, God is an individual. In your theology, in your doctrine, God is not. It's because you diluted it. You diluted it, or you believed in those who diluted it for you. And you just regurgitate what you hear. And I understand why you do that. It's common. It's grandma and grandpa. It's maybe resistance to grandma and grandpa because you don't like what they said, or your dad or your preacher that you grew up with or whatever. But it has to be him and him alone. That's the whole point of one Lord. One Lord. That's the simplicity that is in Christ. For I've determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ and him crucified. Paul said that. He said that. Why would he be determined not to know anything among you save Jesus Christ? Shouldn't he know about the Father? Shouldn't he know that? Shouldn't he tell you about the Father? Of course he should. And he did. And he told them all about the Father, because he told them about Jesus Christ. That's who he told them about. I want to go to the one where I say I'm concerned about the salvation issue. I'm not saying people aren't saved, because to believe a lie, you can say it'll send you to hell. Obviously, believing certain lies will send you to hell. But who believes perfectly? I don't claim to believe perfectly. But you go to 1 John chapter 2, 22. It says, who is a liar but he that denieth that Jesus is the Christ? Okay, that's one person. This is called the antecedent in grammar. There's one person established. A person is a liar who denies that Jesus is the Christ. Jesus is the Christ. That's the one person we're talking about here. Second half of that verse. He is antichrist that denieth the Father and the Son. He did not mention the Father and the Son as separate individuals. He did mention the Father and the Son. But the Father and the Son is Jesus. Jesus is God who came as the Christ. That's who he is. That's who your God is. That's one individual. That's why you can't deny one without denying the other. If they were two people, you could deny one and not deny the other. That would be possible, but it's not possible. To deny one is to deny the other. He's just illustrating a point that God came as the Son. Thou art my Son. This day have I begotten thee. He birthed himself into the world. He brought himself into the world. He sent himself into the world. So shall my word be that go forth into the world. It's him. His word is him. He is his word. That's what he did. You got to get this right. You're clinging to doctrines that declare who God is not, what God is not. And I know that's not what you think about when you say those things, but that is what you're saying. And that's the trick of the devil. That's his subtlety. He'll try whatever works. With Adam and Eve, it worked that way. Hey, you can be like gods. Now we look at that and say, well, I don't want to be like God. I just want to learn about good and evil and be just like Jesus. What? Every church, every single church is built on learn about good and evil and be like God. Every single church is doing exactly what the devil told us to do. How can you think that it's not possible that you would be diminishing your God? I'm not saying this to point the finger at you. I'm saying this to wake you up. You got to wake up, people. You're believing an utter and total lie. Everyone's different. I can just go by people I run into. But they will fight. They will fight and they will pull that veil down over their eyes and over their heart and plug their ears so that there's no way they're ever going to believe that God isn't three people. They know that the Father is not the Son. The Son is not the Father. God is not the Son. God is not the Father. Of course, the poor Holy Ghost, he always gets left out in the cold in these things. No one really argues about that. Like I say, I'm a little bit focused on the two because that's who I've been talking to more lately. The people that say Jesus is just a man or Jesus is one of two people. I've been talking to the three people believers. But think about that. I ask you to really think about that. You're diminishing God. How is that not diminishing God? And when you look at this, it says it clearly. Who is a liar? But he that denies that Jesus is the Christ. That is the Father and the Son. Jesus is the Christ. Jesus is the Almighty God who came as the Messiah. That's who your God is. He came in the flesh because he existed throughout eternity past as Jesus, Yeshua, Yahweh is salvation. He came as the Messiah. He came in the flesh. The already existing one came as that man. The form, the shape, the mannerism, the manifestation in which he came was new as that man. But the God living in him wasn't. The God living in him was the same God that talked to Moses, the same God that said, let there be light, the same God that spoke with Abraham, had a meal with him, the same God that wrestled with Jacob, the same God that gave the prophets all that wisdom, and the same God that walked with the 12. And when he showed himself to Thomas, Thomas declared, my Lord and my God. That's your God. You want to know him. You want to know him. You don't want to know religion. You don't want to have all the facets and all the theology and all the doctrines down pat so that you can look to the left and look to the right and get your amens and give your amens. You don't want that. You want him. Don't you? Don't you want your God? It's all about him and him alone. There is no other. He is the Lord. He is our Savior. And there is no other. There's none beside him. Don't let that be diluted. And don't be the one diluting it. Don't be the one diminishing him. Don't do that. All doors are open then. Then you can have all these other faiths, all these baptisms, all these lords. Don't do that. Don't do that to him. Think about him. How do you think that makes him feel? He loves you. He gave himself for you. The Son of God. The eternal God who came here to give himself for you. That's what he did. So you could get to know him. And you can't get to know him if you think he's a them. You are the God in that system because you get to choose which one of them you commune with, walk with, talk with. There's no sense or logic in that. There's no compassion. There may be passion in you fighting to believe it. But you don't want that. You want him, don't you? And you can have him right now if you just believe in him. That one Lord of that one faith who baptizes you with the one baptism of his Spirit. The Spirit of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, amen.